Photosynthesis is done by all these green leaves which are seen around. The green colored pigment called chlorophyll is present in all these leaves of the various plants, shrubs and trees around what you are seeing, like the, in this neem tree and the various trees and plants, even in this plant of cactus which is a succulent, you can see the stem is generally doing photosynthesis, but in this case the leaves are doing photosynthesis because leaves are green in color and stem is brown in color. As you can see here, the stem is brown in color and the leaves are green in color. All these green leaves have a green colored pigment which is called as chlorophyll, and chlorophyll helps in photosynthesis by the green leaves. Now let's see some grasses. These grasses also have green color, and by these green colored grasses they also do photosynthesis. We can see a variety of plants around us and all of them do photosynthesis by their green leaves. See this aloe vera or Dhrut Kumari. Now aloe vera is a succulent. Leaves are very thick and they have spines on their edges. They are but greenish in color, and you can see here in the aloe vera the stem is this region will be the stem, and that is brownish in color, and these are the leaves which are green in color and which do photosynthesis. So green colored pigment if present in the leaves, it will do photosynthesis. See all the trees around you, they are having green leaves and they are all doing photosynthesis. All of them are called as the kitchen of the plant because they are doing photosynthesis. You can see in this plant the fruits are red in color but the leaves are very green. So these green leaves are actually doing photosynthesis and they are producing the food which is transported by these stems to the various parts of the plant. And you can see in the leaves also there are veins. Reticulate venation is shown by this leaf. So these veins which are spread all around the leaf, it helps in transport of food prepared by this kitchen of the plant to the various parts of the plant. It even goes up till the roots of the plant, and these fruits and all other parts of the plant, they develop because of these green colored leaves which are doing photosynthesis process. Lemongrass, you can see this is the lemongrass. Its scientific name is Cymbopogon atratus. It acts as an insect repellent. It gives the flavor of lemon. You can add it to tea and you can use it. This is also green in color. It shows that photosynthesis is occurring. This is elaichi plant. Elaichi plant also does photosynthesis. See, the flowers are developing and the various parts of the plant develop because of the photosynthesis done by the leaves. So in the process of photosynthesis as done by these wonderful leaves, the green colored pigment chlorophyll is required, and the plants take from the under surface of the leaves, at the under surface, like these under surfaces of the leaves, there are very very minute pores called as stomata, through which the plants take in carbon dioxide, and utilizing the sunlight, in the presence of the sunlight, these plants, using water which is taken up by the roots of these plants, they convert the carbohydrate into starch. And in this process oxygen is released, which is very very essential for all the organisms around us. All the living beings are able to survive because of the photosynthesis which is done by the green leaves. As these green plants and leaves are eaten by us, and because of the photosynthesis process only, these plants are able to produce food in their leaves. So they are known as autotrophs, and these other parts of the plant like these flowers, they develop because of this process of photosynthesis as the plant needs energy for all this. And once they develop, they give rise to fruit. And once the fruits develop, they are also eaten by the living beings. And like this cycle goes on. So when living organisms, they get energy. We are all able to do work. Herbal plant which gives the fragrance of onion. So you can see these fruits will be formed and seeds are formed, and like this propagation of the plants occur. And because of this, life is surviving. Because of these autotrophs which are producing food, life is surviving on earth. Leaves of the plants like this gourd which has grown up the tree, you can see it is very green in color, and all of this does the photosynthesis process. Because of photosynthesis, it is able to produce all these flowers and fruits, as these leaves are the kitchens of the plant and they produce starch in them with the help of the sunlight which is falling on them, utilizing carbon dioxide available in the atmosphere. So leaves are also help in reducing the global warming, as they are utilizing carbon dioxide, and in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll pigment on their leaves, they are doing photosynthesis, they are producing starch on the leaves and releasing oxygen in the process. So they are helping the other organisms to survive around them. Now the amount of oxygen which they release by photosynthesis is more than the amount of oxygen which they consume in the process of respiration. So that's why the plants are said to be the lungs of the environment. See these variegated leaves in the leaf margin or the edges of the leaves, and in the midrib part you can see it is more green in color, so chlorophyll will be more produced in these green parts of the leaf, while in the white parts of the leaf the production of starch will be very less and photosynthesis will occur less. And green parts will produce all the food which is needed by the plant. You can see here variegated leaves of money plant. In these variegated leaves of money plant, in these green parts, chlorophyll is present, so photosynthesis will be occurring in these plants. And if we do the starch test by taking this leaf and boiling it in spirit in a double boiler with water in the beaker, if we keep the test tube with this leaf and spirit, and then green color is gone from the leaf, then when we do the iodine test, that is starch test, we will see that in these green parts starch will be visible or blue black color will be obtained, while in the white parts there will not be much starch in the leaves. So variegated leaves have also photosynthesis process occurs in them also, like in these money plants. And the photosynthesis occurs more in the portions where there is green pigment of these leaves. Pothos plant, you see the variegated leaves are there, it looks so beautiful. The chlorophyll is present in these green plants. White plants have very little chlorophyll. So mainly photosynthesis will be occurring in these green plants. And if we do this starch test, these green portions of the variegated leaves will show blue-black color, while the white portions will not show much blue-black color. These are the coleus leaves which look so wonderful. You can see they are having these maroon colors and green color on one side, and on the margins, leaf margins or leaf blade, it is green in color. So actually these leaves have in these green parts chlorophyll, and in these maroon parts they are having some other pigments which are called as anthocyanin and flavonoids. So anthocyanin and flavonoids are giving this coleus this wonderful color, and these also do photosynthesis, and food is stored in the green parts of the leaf. All these green parts of the leaf store the food because of the presence of chlorophyll. So green pigment chlorophyll is necessary for photosynthesis. But these leaves also do photosynthesis, and this color comes because of the presence of other pigment in these leaves. These leaves are having anthocyanin pigment which makes it reddish in color, as you can see, the red or maroon color in the leaves is because of the pigment anthocyanin. But these also do photosynthesis because some of the leaves are green here in this plant. Like you can see, these leaves are green, so they do photosynthesis and produce starch in these green leaves. These colorful leaves, as you are seeing here, these are having anthocyanin in them. That's why they have got this color, that is maroon or red color. In this colorful variegated plant, you see the chlorophyll will be produced more in these green parts, while the white parts will not be having any chlorophyll, or much chlorophyll is not there in these white parts in these variegated leaves. So most starch will be produced by the chlorophyll in these green parts, and the white parts will be having very less chlorophyll produced in them. In this Tradescantia leaf, the pigment anthocyanin is present in much amount. That's why it is having this maroon color. But these leaves also do photosynthesis for survival, and that's why these flowers are produced in these. Green leaves of these plants do photosynthesis. Now some of the leaves of your Sadabahar or Periwinkle, you can see they have become yellow in color. Actually these are the old leaves which are now going to fall down because they are not doing properly photosynthesis and they have become old. So when they become old, they turn into this yellowish color. Sometime due to deficiency of phosphorus and potassium, sometimes they become yellowish in color. So deficiency also is shown by the leaves by change in color. Otherwise, leaves are generally green in color as they do photosynthesis and they have the green colored pigment called chlorophyll in them. That's why they are able to produce these lovely flowers and fruits in these plants. Some of the leaves of hibiscus have become yellow in color. That may be because the leaves are old or they have got the pigment flavonoids. Flavonoids give the orange and yellow color to these leaves. So there are various types of pigments found in these leaves, but main pigment needed for photosynthesis is chlorophyll, which helps in producing starch in these leaves. So I hope you have learnt a lot from these wonderful plants around you. So don't forget to stay tuned to your own channel, that is Unique Learning. Be a part of the channel, subscribe and share with your friends. Happy learning.